If you own a 3D printer, you will sooner or later wonder if and how you could use waste plastics instead of filament to print. That's exactly why I've built an extruder that can handle plastic granules. As usually, I've searched for ways to create a mechanics that works without special parts. The central element of an extruder is the screw conveyor, which presses the granules into the hot end. The screw of my first extruder was composed of a 3mm threaded rod wrapped with copper wire. It works in principle, but I have not been able to achieve really good results. Especially after cooling, it was very difficult to get the extruder going again. Some of the threads were always clogged with partially molten plastic. After mediating on the problem for a couple of nights, I now follow a non-conventional approach. While with classic extruders, the screw conveyor reaches from the cold to the hot zone, I am now using a screw that only goes into the cold zone. The loose granules are compacted in this zone, and the so formed clot is pushed into the hot zone by the stream of granules. The granules get entangled and so can't go back up through the gap, as would be the case with liquid plastic. With this system, the gap between screw and wall of the bore can be rather large, so that the requirements for the precision of the whole system are rather low. To make the system work, the granules must slide quite well along the wall of the tube. I am using a piece of Teflon tubing having a larger diameter than in conventional filament extruders that use this material for the same reason. I did some experimentation with different diameters and geometries for my type of screw conveyor. Among them were various copper wire wound types as well as conventional metal and wood screws. In an early experiment I used a commercially available 3mm screw in the metal tube of the standard hot end. In the 4mm bore hole there is no space left for a Teflon tube. The whole thing worked, but only with very fine granules, which are hard to make from old plastics. With a 6mm threaded rod in a Teflon tube with an inner diameter of 8mm I could process clearly larger granules. However, the result did not really convince me. The smaller the diameter, the better the mechanical transmission. The smaller the volume of granules moved per revolution of the extruder screw, the better you can control the flow of plastics coming out of the nozzle. With 0.5mm copper wire wrapped on a 3mm screw in a Teflon tube with 5mm inner diameter, the results were pretty good. I have achieved even better results with a 3mm wood screw in the 5mm Teflon tube. I have extended the screw with a piece of 3mm threaded rod, not perfectly centered, but it works. The hot end is made of a piece of 16x16mm aluminum. There are two holes for two heating cartridges. However, in my storage I have found a very powerful cartridge that does the job, so that there was no need for a second one. The tests were carried out on a Sonster printer of the P802 series. The more powerful heating cartridge has blown the transistor for the hot end on the motherboard after a few minutes. As a bypass, I'm now using a MOSFET that can switch currents of up to 20 amps, that should be more than sufficient. The hot end is bolted to a second piece of 16x16mm aluminum using two pieces of 3mm threaded rod, this part is cooled by a fan. As a thermal insulation I've wrapped the hot end with two layers of special cardboard as used for engine gaskets. Normal cardboard carbonizes at temperatures of 200 degrees Celsius and more. I was using exhaust sealant to glue the insulation. The rest of the mechanics, including the hopper, is printed from PLA. The entire printhead is quite shaky, there is a clear need for improvement here. Here I'm printing PLA with a layer thickness of 0.2mm. The print speed is consistently set to 10mm per second. I also set the extrusion width in slicer to 0.3mm. A nozzle with 0.4mm bore is used. The speed for movements without extrusion is set to 150mm per second. The direct extruder must deliver a constant flow of plastics out of the nozzle while being fed with irregularly shaped grains. A piece of sheet metal on the conveyor screw acts as a granule stirrer which compacts the granules slightly before they enter the extruder, a simple component that has noticeably improved the printing results. Due to the direct drive, the screw can be moved very quickly whenever the granules are retracted, which is important in order to fight stringing. A couple of things have to be considered to get the right sort of granules from the right sort of plastics. How to get useful granules from waste plastic is shown in another video. The sidewalls are printed smoothly and without gaps, which is an indication for a constant extrusion without air bubbles. All in all, the quite simple construction works fine. The object printed here is only 27x25x12mm large. Small parts like this track link for a robot vehicle reveal the weak points of a printing system better than large prints in waste mode do. The print job was finished after about 1 hour. The comparison with the white reference print done with my Ender having a conventional filament extruder shows that there is still room for improvement, but considering the early prototype stage, the result is quite good. The printed parts can be assembled to a working track. How fast can we go? Well, here I'm printing with 20mm per second. And here with 30mm per second. As you can see, the printhead starts shaking hardly at that speed, the mechanics is brought to its limits. However, the extruder still delivers the required flow rate of plastics with no problem. With a more compact printhead design and a more stable attachment to the linear bearings of the X-axis, the results should become better. This is the current stage of my development. Not bad for a start, is it? What can be improved? I've ordered glass tubes to check if they are suitable as a replacement for the Teflon tubes. To completely eliminate such exotic materials, I'm experimenting with a slightly conical bore with a larger opening pointing towards the hot end, as well as further changes in the geometry of my extruder. With a flexible shaft, the width of the moving parts of the printhead can be reduced, the stepper motor can be attached to the printer frame as with conventional Bowden extruders. Shredded waste plastic is never free of containments, a filter in the hot end prevents clogging of the nozzle. The direct granules extruder is quite sensitive to stringing, and here I'm investigating two ideas. A longer screw reaches to the molten plastic in the hot end, but the thread in the middle section is removed. The motor coupling lifts the screw whenever the direction of rotation is reversed. However, friction of the tiny screw is too small to passively allow the lifting process, possibly a ratchet mechanism is the solution. You could also lower the screw and so close the nozzle. Let's see what works best. On my pages you can find the build instruction, the 3D files of the parts and photos of sample prints with this direct granule extruder. There's still something to optimize, if you would like to support me in my efforts, you can click on the donate button on my pages, many thanks to all existing backers. Thanks for watching and I'll be back.